Hey friends, quick plug here. Sonic Toast mascot stickers are now available at my eBay store. Link in the description below. Enjoy the video.
Here we are, friends, with part two of our 2.5-inch Mario movie figure reviews. And in our last video, I didn't even think to put Mario next to the movie Sonic figure. I actually really like how they look together. I think they actually look pretty cool. I mean, this is going back to the Sonic being bigger than Mario proportion, which is not completely accurate, but I think they look cool enough together. I actually posted some pictures on my Instagram if you want to see them. There is a link to my Instagram in the description of this video. Anyway, moving past Mario now, because you guys asked for it, we are doing Princess Peach today. That sounded weird. We are reviewing Princess Peach today. Just like Mario and the others, this one is also pull back and go. And this, I believe, is our first action figure of Peach in her motorcycle outfit from Mario Kart. Well, this is of course from the movie, but the outfit is inspired by her outfit that she wears in Mario Kart. So here is Peach out of the box. Definitely a great sculpt. Lots of good detail on her boots, on her gloves, on her helmet, on her suit. Everything looks very textured, very detailed. Same thing on the motorcycle. We have a good paint job on the colors with the pink and the gray and the gold. Really cool looking. Now let's look at some of the figure articulation here. We have the ball joint on the head, letting you move her head in all kinds of crazy directions. We got some good shoulder articulation there. No bending elbows, no swivel in the wrists. So her hands are always facing backwards like that. We have articulation in the legs, and unlike Mario, she has bending knees, giving her a total of 7 points of articulation. That's 2 more than Mario. Now here's how she looks sitting on her motorcycle. One thing I really like about this figure is that she does have holes in the bottom of her feet, so you can peg her right into the little pedals or whatever these are on a motorcycle. Also, there is a spare seat here, so like, I don't know if Mario can sit there and ride along with her. No, he doesn't seem to fit right. How about Sonic? See, Sonic can ride along with Peach. Let's go. You need a helmet, Sonic. Wee-hee! Oof. See, told you. There we go. That way Sonic is on better. Now, let's go for a ride. Wee-hee! And it appears Peach fits in Mario's cart just fine. Also, Sonic can ride on Peach's motorcycle. And so that's kind of fun. These figures are the right sizes to where you can interchange them with the different vehicles. And Peach can ride on the back with Sonic driving the motorcycle. So there's all kinds of fun combos you can do with these figures. And you can also kind of fit Sonic and Mario on the bike together. Because I know everybody here has always been dreaming of seeing Sonic and Mario driving a pink motorcycle together. One thing they did really well with this figure is having this whole unit at the bottom here with these wheels. That's what makes it roll, not the actual motorcycle wheels. However, it seems hidden enough, it's well balanced, does not fall down like some motorcycle toys do, and it just works really well. I am actually impressed with this Peach figure. Well, I was impressed with the Mario too, but I think it's got great articulation, great sculpt, and a very, very well functioning vehicle. Only thing I don't love is that the helmet cannot be removed. I'm sure that'd be something hard to do, but an interchangeable head would be nice. Maybe I'm just being spoiled by NECA, but I just would love to see her without the helmet on. That's all. Overall, great figure, highly recommend. I recommend both of these. And I can't wait to review the Koopa Troopa and Toad next. So, friends, thank you so much for watching. Tell me if you picked this one up for your collection yet, and have a fantastic day. Toast!